So last weekend, I went down to Curry Hammock, just north of Marathon in the Florida Keys, and it was beautiful weather, some nice light wind, oh, maybe 13 miles an hour. I was riding my 14 meter pivot by Nash, however you say that, and just having a great time. And this is the day I knew I needed to try backrolls because it was a perfect conditions. And this was my very first attempt ever at a backroll. Look at me lining up everything, checking it out, looking at my kite, rehearsing, thinking. And bam, I was actually pretty excited because I kind of got all the way around, even though I crashed. I knew what I did wrong. I pulled on my backhand, looped the kite. But this is why you want to do this on a calm day or like a light wind day. So if you loop the kite, you don't pay for it big time. Second try. Didn't commit enough to carving to commit the rotation. But you could see it right away, like you knew that wasn't going to work. No, another fail. I didn't carve hard enough. I didn't commit. And I'm not like turning my head like into the rotation like you're supposed to. So here's a little body drag to come back to get my board. Another try. Oh. Oh, I committed to the rotation that time. Then I over-rotated. So, but that was actually good because I felt it like, oh wow, that's how you do it. And then once again, like, well, actually I completed it. I actually did complete it, but I didn't ride it out and I crashed the kite. Oh yeah, got it. Yeehaw. So what was that? Five or six tries? Today, this was the first day I ever even attempted a back roll. But I could feel it. I knew it was going to work. I knew I was going to get it. And I think I was just ready to do it because my jumps were very consistent by now. Like they were almost instinctive. Oh, and I should point out, I hadn't even ridden for like maybe probably 3 months. I hadn't even kited for like 3 months. The summer here in Fort Myers, there was just no wind. There was no wind in the Keys, maybe a little bit on and off, but I hadn't kited in a while. And I was happy that it like came right back to me. So I felt super comfortable with my basic jumps and then just adding that commitment to do the rotation. And the mistake I kept making was just pulling on my backhand. And apparently that's a common mistake. But this is the time to try it when there's nice, gentle, light wind, so you don't pay for it. I'm not sure what I did there. I completed the rotation, but I must have been pulling on my backhand. It probably backlooped the kite. Nice form. Oh, yeah. Not pretty, but I did it. That's two now. I'm pumped. Two, yeah. I was pumped. I was having such a good time. Oh, three. This is like the most fun I've had in a long time kiting. Okay, I'm starting to get the feel of it. Not perfect, but I could feel it. I was focusing more on my front hand, like waiting till I like felt like I made the rotation and then pull in on the front hand and it pulled me out. This was such a perfect day. Oh, except for the crashes. You can see I was riding my big board, the 154 Crazy Fly. But man, when it's super light and that board in combination with the 14 meter pivot, it's awesome. This is why you want to practice learning new tricks on a light day. Gotta retrieve my hat. Oh, yeah, by then the board had drifted downwind a little bit, so I dragged down to get it. Like, even though I might not be smiling all the time, I'm actually, like, so stoked at this point. Oh, yeah. Oops. Yeah. I must have done like 20 or 30 back rolls. You know, I'd never tried any to the other direction. Cause, like, going left foot forward, going to the left, that's like my strongest. Well, these people were out on this sandbar, like maybe a half mile off the beach. I had to go out there and check it out. Oh, yeah, getting it. Like, I just didn't want to quit. I was having so much fun. The GoPro actually ran out of batteries, and so I had to go into the beach and put a new battery in it. I was definitely getting the feel. Not that these are perfect or anything, but I was landing them and it was just like very comfortable to commit to do it now. That was the cool part. It was like, man, I'm ready to go. Let's keep trying. Let's get this dialed in. It's all good. This is fun stuff. Oh, yeah. Still stoked. I think by then I was just getting tired. I kited 4 days or 4 days, 4 hours on Saturday, and I think this was approaching like 5 o'clock on Sunday. And I think I was out there since maybe, I don't know, 10. And I still had to drive 5 hours back home. Yeah, I was getting tired. But I am definitely pumped up for my next session. Gonna do like some backroll transitions. So I went back out to the sandbar. These people rented a, that's them in the background there. They rented this little pontoon boat. I'm like, yeah, baby, a little 50 horse Yamaha. Super simple. So I was checking it out. I'm so tired of like boats that are too complicated. So I'm thinking about a pontoon. Be tricked out for kiteboarding. Which means it'll have nothing on it. No seats, just an open deck in the front.